determine the best landing spot, 30 degrees to the right, 30 degrees to the left. Above traffic pattern, attitude non-critical, stay in the pattern and land, full stop. Above the traffic pattern attitude, and critical, we will try to land in the nearest runway. Winds are coming from 160, but it's really weak, so we will disregard the parking brake release. Facing north, run up complete. Firm. Happy. Way 25 by a taxi. Taxi by a Charlie Delta. Happy Grand Prix.
I have to work on my
clothes. Okay, left clear, front clear, right clear. I will look out for the hotspots and make my call outs when we pass. set it to 20 full power and 7 the brake.
No, wait, that's a short stop. I meant stop. Stop.
Okay. So at 51 rotate.
Okay.
No, you're gonna keep full elevator
back pressure. Okay, let's go. Okay.
Use Smyrna Tower red Epic Red 580 ready for southbound departure, runway 25. we're landing.
Yeah.
Oh, wing flaps is up. Mixture lean. Transponder reset to 1200 and lights as required.
Cool. All right, let's go.
Okay, so we'll go here.
Yeah.
Okay. Clear from here. Okay.
Let you breathe for a minute. So that was a lot kind of launch at once, right?
Yeah.
So you have to multitask.
Yes.
Like, there really is no such thing as multitasking, just tests. So you have to try to think about what's most effective right now. What do I need to do? So the order follow is as follows. Deviate. So fly the plane first, navigate, and then communicate. Okay? So at the very minimum, you need to fly the plane first. So what do you need to do to fly the plane? Then, after that, you're going to navigate, and then at the very least thing you're going to do is communicate. That's the last step of the process. So you have to aviate, then navigate, then communicate. Okay? As far as entering the pattern, you know, you kind of went through that process. I think we just got a little bit behind the plate. We had a pretty good tailwind. So we got to delay really good, because we had a pretty good tailwind, especially once we turned towards the land. So little tips for you as far as like determining like how to get into the airport, and how like it's got multiple runways, it's kind of confusing, okay? Number one, okay, just the easiest tip I can give you, let me see your airport diagram. Yeah, for the way. So now you, like, if you're coming from New Smyrna, you're gonna be looking down the pipe of 30. So that'll just help give you orientation. You're like, oh, I'm looking at 30 right now. So that'll give you that orientation. It's like, all right, cool. If I'm looking at 30, I'm landing on 12. Well, if I'm looking at 30, I'm standing down the barrel of 12. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So that kind of gives you some orientation. Once you kind of figure out that orientation as well, you can twist that paper around to where, like, the way you see the airport when you're looking outside is how you see it on the airport diagram. Another tip, bug your runway heading. If you bug your runway heading, you know right now we're on like a downwind heading right now. And your 45 degree is always going to be left side with that downwind heading. So you know your 45 degree entry is that way. Now put the airport right here in the middle. Alright?
Yes.
So, kind of figure out where you are and then fly that heading if that makes any sense whatsoever. But those are some little tips that kind of help you get in and out of the land because it is kind of confusing. Alright, cool. So I'm going to show you a short field takeoff. That, or sorry, I keep saying soft field takeoff.
Okay.
Okay? I know you've done shorts, we're going to do softs now.
Okay.
Alright, so I'm going forward landing. Everything looks good. Forward takeoff checklist. Alright, I'm on the radio call. Boy, I just said landing. Alright, so when I'm taxi out, I'm simulating that I'm on a grass strip. If you're on a grass strip, you want to keep as much weight off the nose wheel as possible. The reason for that is because there's ruts and stuff like that. You can dig the nose wheel into the ground and fucking clean it. So that's the worst case scenario. So I'm going to taxi out and I'm going to have full elevator aft back pressure. Okay? And I'm not going to use any brakes. Now granted, at this point, I might have to use a little bit of brakes just because the rudders don't really want to work. But I'm going to taxi out pretty slow. Okay? Alright, runway 12 is confirmed. I'm going to slow this for any more power. It's a slow progression of full power. And watch what happens to my nose. See how it comes up? Yes. That's okay. I love my nose. I'm going to vlog that first. Got a bit of that.
wraps up.
Thank you. Oh, yep. Good.
Yep.
All right, now let the nose come down. All right, flaps up.
ground effect. I'm gonna do that for a while until it goes to
60 knots.
Yeah, pretty much. So 56. You're gonna climb out at 56.
Level off.
Not necessarily level off. If you're above 60, you have positive rate climb above 200 feet. Yeah, we're actually. Alright, cool. You need your 410 to take off your car.
Strobe. It's Rich.
Flaps 10.
Flaps 10, because I'm sure it's up there.
Just announce it. We're going to announce it. Take off. Go ahead and keep going. Yeah, I got the radios. right, sorry. I kind of took the Joel's. I knew there was a lot of short final. I knew we had to go all the way down to Charlie.